Good morning, everyone. My name is Sierra Angeles from Delivery Base Owners. Today we gather with our drivers, coalitions, members of our community, industry leaders, many of us concerned as to what's going on in our industry. We need some answers. The taxi industry is vital to keep New York moving. And we need to remain strong and prosperous for years to come. But we cannot do it alone. We can't. We call on city and state office officials to stand up for the workers of this industry, our businesses, and our community. We call on our elected leaders to work with us to rectify the over-enforcement and keep our industry economically viable. Our drivers, we went from assaults, homicides, and now we are in suicides. This is a very critical moment in which we need to pay attention to the health and the quality of life of our drivers. We are united here. The CGT, which is the coordinator of taxi drivers, the Coalition of Taxi Drivers of the City of New York, GNTNY, Assetini, and many others, Townie, many other organizations and their leaders, paying respects to the brothers that have given their lives on behalf of this industry. And now we are here looking for solutions to make this a better situation for the men and women of our communities. Estamos aquí hoy dándole las gracias a los medios por estar aquí con nosotros. Reunidos líderes, dueños de bases, líderes comunitarios, líderes choferiles, diferentes organizaciones que se han reunido hoy para demandar una respuesta de nuestros gobernantes que han abandonado esta industria, nos han dejado solos y hoy tenemos que proteger los trabajos de los hombres y mujeres de nuestras comunidades y evitar que así como pasamos de los asaltos a los homicidios, hoy estamos en suicidios y tres de nuestros compañeros han perdido su vida en busca de mejorar. Nos hemos unido con la Asociación de Bases y la Coalición de Taxistas, GNTNY, Townie, todos los miembros de nuestra industria, Sotini, todos los líderes comunitarios han venido a respaldar y a preservar los trabajos de los hombres y mujeres de nuestra comunidad, que son los que han mantenido a Nueva York moviéndose y no podemos ignorar sus necesidades. Tenemos que proteger sus trabajos para que podamos seguir aquí por años por venir. Esto es simplemente el comienzo de demandar que se rectifiquen las regulaciones, que se le provea una mejor calidad de vida a cada uno de los miembros de esta. Agradecemos que estén aquí y le pedimos ahora al pibe y al señor Leonel Marte unas palabras en nombre de la Coordinadora General de Taxistas.
Tiene que agarrarlo, se va a caer. Ya lo tengo.
Sí, buenos días. Estamos aquí en nombre de la Coordinadora General de Taxistas, CGT.
Yeah, good morning, everyone. We here in representation of the CGT organization.
Nuestra industria está pasando por su peor momento en la historia.
Our industry is going through the worst moment in its history.
Siendo afectado por las regulaciones del Consejo Municipal, que dicho sea de paso, nos impone alta multa impositiva para esta industria. Tienen muchos problemas, pero en esta ocasión vamos a identificar algunos de los problemas.
It is being affected by the regulations and law that the City Council imposed on us. Our industry have a lot of problems, but in this time, we will only take three of them.
Primero, recogida de pasajeros en la calle en los años 70, la ley decía que no podíamos recoger en la calle hasta el día de hoy.
First of all, pick up passengers on the street. In the 70s was created a law that did not allow pick passengers in the street.
Los choferes aceptaron dicha ley porque la base en esa, desde ese entonces no proveían muchos pasajeros.
The drivers accepted the law because the delivery company were giving us many passengers.
Pero hoy en día eso no sucede porque las aplicaciones, entiéndase Uber, Lyft, etcétera, se han llevado la mayoría de los pasajeros.
Times have changed and companies such as Uber, Lyft, Junior and others came on the scene and they have taken a very high percentage of the climb.
Segundo punto.
Second point.
La alta multa por parte de la TLC todos los días a los choferes de New York, a los choferes de New York reciben alta multa siempre, simple como.
All right. Second, the high fine by the TLC department. Every single day, the drivers of New York City are receiving fines for simple things like
carro sucio, $500.
Dirty car, $500.
Un vaso de café dentro de nuestra unidad, $250.
A cup of coffee inside the car, $250.
Y estas leyes, estas reglamentaciones abusivas, llevan multa hasta de $10,000.
All right.
La CGT. Ok, continuamos. Esta multa abusiva conlleva multa hasta de $10,000.
Pick up passengers on the street, the fines are $1,000, $2,000, and $10,000 and up.
La CGT, en representación de la clase libre de New York, quiere que esa multa sea eliminada y toda la licencia sean retornadas a nuestros choferes que se, a las cuales le han quitado injustamente por estas leyes abusivas.
The CGT in representation of all single drivers of the New York City want to eliminate those fines and all licenses are returned to our drivers.
Finalmente, la CGT se compromete a continuar la lucha hasta que nuestros reclamos sean reconocidos en el Consejo Municipal. Gracias.
Thank you.
From the Coalition of Taxi Drivers, Pedro Joaquin Aguilar.
Primeramente, quiero darle las gracias a Dios y luego darle las gracias a todos los medios de comunicación y a todos los compañeros taxistas que estamos aquí reunidos. Antes de comenzar nuestras palabras, queremos rezar un Padre Nuestro a la memoria de los tres compañeros que se quitaron la vida, el compañero Alfredo Pérez de la base de Yunica, el compañero Danilo Corporán de la base de Premium, que se lanzó de un quinto piso, y el compañero Douglas Chester, que aquí mismo en ese local, en ese lugar, vino y se dio un tiro en la cabeza por los abusos y los atropellos de la TLC. Levanten sus flores blancas para rezar el Padre Nuestro, para que esos compañeros que están en el cielo nos escuchen a nosotros y estamos aquí cumpliendo su misión de defenderlo hasta la muerte. Padre nuestro que estás en el cielo, santificado sea tu nombre. Venga a nosotros tu reino. Hágase su voluntad en la tierra como en el cielo. El pan nuestro de cada día. Dánoslos hoy, Señor. Perdona nuestras ofensas, como también nosotros perdonamos a los que nos ofenden. No nos dejes caer en tentación, mas líbranos del mal. Amén. ¡Que viva el alma de Danilo Corporán, de Alfredo Pérez y de Douglas Chester! Compañero, Aquí estamos para emprender nuestra lucha y nuestra defensa. Que Dios lo acoja en su santo seno. Muchas gracias.
Gracias. Gracias, Pedro Joaquín Aguilar, por tan emotivas palabras. Thank you, the coalition, for some emotional words. We also honor the memory of those who gave their lives on behalf of their industry, who felt that there was no way to go, who felt that there was no more fight to fight. We are here to say that we will continue until we find that common ground in which we can all come together. I would love to introduce, I also want to acknowledge our president, Jose Altamirano from the Livery-Based Owners Association. And now, someone that actually promised when he came to the city council that he was going to take a look at everything that was happening with the TLC, with the industry, with the growth, with the laws in place, with enforcement. And that is someone that we appreciate how much he has committed his time and himself to bring solutions to the table, something that works for all of us. Yo quiero ahora presentar a una persona que prometió que iba a hacer una revisión clara de todo lo que estaba pasando en la industria, desde sus leyes, la manera como se hacían cumplir y todo lo que está pasando para traer una mejor calidad de vida a nuestra industria. Y esa persona es el reverendo concejal Rubén Díaz.
Gracias, Ira. Good morning. As you know, as you could see, today we are doing something historic. Thanks to the new council member president, the Honorable Corey Johnson, he created a special committee to deal with for hire vehicle. And he appointed me to be the chair of that committee. And knowing the suffering, the abuses, the torture that the drivers are going through, I'm happy that today we have our first hearing, our first public hearing. And as you could see, there are many, many drivers here, many members of the industry concerned with what's going on. So today, the commissioner of Taxi and Limousine will be testifying, among others, and we hope to find solution because the situation is getting very, very difficult, very dangerous. We got people taking their life, people breaking cars, people are doing all kind of thing to show their anger, to show their frustration with the TLC. I'm glad that the mayor yesterday this weekend in the news, the mayor realized that something has to be done, and he said that something will be done. So, en esta mañana estamos aquí dándole las gracias primeramente al señor, luego dándole las gracias al presidente del Consejo Municipal, Cabri Johnson, quien ha creado un comité nuevo especial para tratar con los asuntos de la TLC y me ha nombrado a mí como el presidente de ese comité. Y como podemos ver, mira, que hay un sinnúmero de miembros de la industria para expresar sus frustraciones. Hoy tenemos nuestras primeras vistas públicas donde la comisionada va a testificar y donde esperamos conseguir soluciones. La situación se ha puesto caótica, miembros de la industria se han quitado la vida expresando su disgusto por la forma en que son tratados por la TLC. Y nos alegramos que el alcalde en este fin de semana ha expresado preocupación, ha expresado su deseo de hacer algo para cambiar ciertas leyes. Así que gracias a cada uno de estos miembros de la industria, a Cira y a cada una de las personas que están preocupadas y que han venido luchando por años y años con estos abusos. Así que muchas gracias y esperamos verlos adentro en nuestras vistas públicas a las 10 de la mañana. Gracias.
On behalf of the bases that affiliate the drivers in the city, Damian Rodriguez, Executive Director of Delivery Based Owners, would also like to say a few words.
Good morning, everyone. Hoy, lunes, apenas hacen ocho días que van a quedar en la historia de la ciudad de Nueva York, que no van a ser posible borrarlo. 8 días que en esa puerta ahí, un compañero de la industria decidió, por las frustraciones que llevamos todos, por las frustraciones que no han venido las autoridades ignorando por muchísimo tiempo. Y todos juntos podemos hacer la diferencia y recordar que la vida de los que ya han tomado desafortunadamente y que no podemos recuperarla, que no suceda en uno de nuestros compañeros. Esta ciudad, este país, que es el país de los sueños, para nosotros los taxistas se está convirtiendo en pesadilla, que es una realidad que ha sido ignorada por los políticos y no pueden decir como en otras ocasiones que la industria no está organizada, que nosotros no le hemos avisado a tiempo de lo que nos conviene, lo que no nos conviene. También nuestras comunidades están muy preocupadas porque no quieren prescindir de los servicios que nosotros le damos de manera tan eficiente. El llamado es de que todos juntos demos los pasos firmes para evitar más muerte, porque todos juntos ahora mismo podemos hacer la diferencia, que esta industria que viven cientos de miles de padres de familia no podrá ser ignorada por los políticos, que los políticos tienen que darse cuenta que en su momento nosotros vamos también a sacar cuenta con ellos, que no haga un compañero más que muera por las irresponsabilidades de los políticos. Nosotros queremos decir hoy día aquí que estamos dispuestos a esto llevarlo hasta la última consecuencia y que desde la más alta de los cargos políticos hasta el más bajito ya no podrán ignorarnos. Estos suicidios que se han venido dando son lo que nosotros hemos visto en la prensa, por lo que han llegado a morir en los hospitales, por la desesperación, son mucho más que lo que nosotros conocemos. Hoy queremos dejar claro que la comisionada, que el alcalde sean firmes con las decisiones y que se aseguren de que los cientos de padres de familia que estamos aquí hoy día vamos a darle seguimiento hasta la última consecuencia. Muchas gracias.
Bravo, bravo. Sí.
If the members of the press have any questions, si tienen algún tipo de preguntas, este es el momento y luego entramos a la vigilia. Right after this, we'll go right into the hearing.
Morning.
Morning.
What do you think will be done in the immediate to turn the tide of this in the coming months? At least, how long do you think this will take to get the culture, to get all of this to change back in your favor?
I do feel that it's not so much back in our favor, but it's just we asked for the city and the state to sit down and look at what has been happening, the growth, the rules, Vision Zero, and even measures that have been taken to make us compete with unregulated and regulated industries. So we do feel that we need to create the conditions to have a cohesive approach to an industry-wide solution. It's not one thing that was going to bring the quality of life that we are seeking for the drivers. It's just a comprehensive look as to what's been happening in the last 4 or 5 years.
Are you hopeful that we have this new committee that something will change?
We look forward to working with this new committee, and yes, we are hopeful, because for the first time, perhaps somebody will dedicate their time just to look at the TLC issues and the almost 200 licensees that the industry currently has. As you can see, everybody is very saddened by the situation. Everybody feels deeply in their heart that there has been moments in which anyone has felt a sense of despair, a sense of, I don't want to fight this anymore. I don't want to work in this industry anymore. I want to give up my plates. But we are here to say that we are here to put up the fight because we are servicing our community and because these men and women need to keep supporting their families. That's what's important.
Para el problema que tiene el TSA
Nosotros estamos creando un fondo legal para tratar de enfrentar en diferentes niveles lo que puede ser una situación si no tenemos un diálogo comprensivo que enfrente todas las medidas y que proteja también a las personas que muchas veces sienten que no tienen protección. Estamos aquí porque nosotros también dimos fruto a la ley del Boro Taxi y también queremos preservar esos derechos que les pertenecen y les asisten a esos choferes que han hecho esa inversión.
Buenos días, damas y caballeros. Yo soy el reverendo Rubén Díaz, represento el distrito concejal 18 en el condado del Bronx. Gracias a todos por su asistencia y demostrar interés en este tan importante tema. Este comité fue recientemente creado por el honorable portavoz del Consejo Municipal, Corey Johnson, el cual me asignó a mí como presidente del mismo. El Comité de Vehículos para Alquiler está compuesto por otros 6 miembros del Consejo. Ellos son los honorables concejales Idanis Rodríguez de Manhattan, Joseph Borelli y Deborah Rose de Staten Island, Peter Balón, Francisco Moya y Constantine Costa de Queens. O sea, uno del Bronx, uno de Manhattan, 2 de Staten Island y 3 de Queens. El tema que nos ocupa la atención esta mañana son las reglas de enforzamiento y los procedimientos implementados por la Comisión de Taxi y Limusinas, tales como entrampamientos y multas excesivas generadas desde el 2013 hasta el presente. En esta gráfica detrás de mí, producida por la administración del alcalde de la ciudad de Nueva York, demuestra que las multas de la comisión a los taxis han aumentado drásticamente en los últimos 3 años. Este aumento nos hace preguntarnos lo siguiente: ¿cuál es la razón de estos aumentos en estas multas? ¿Los agentes de la TLC han capturado más comportamiento incorrecto de parte de la industria de taxis? ¿Está la TLC usando estas multas excesivas como forma de aumentar los ingresos para su agencia? Y más importante, ¿dónde y en qué parte de la ciudad se han llevado a cabo estos enforzamientos? ¿Se está haciendo lo mismo en el condado en Manhattan, donde están los hoteles y donde están?
Stand and give the oath along with your members. You don't have to stand, but to the extent that your other executive staff will do it at once. Do you swear to tell the truth and answer honestly as best as possible to the members of this committee?
I do.
Thank you.
And members of the for-hire committee, I'm Mira Zoshi, Commissioner and Chair of the New York City Taxi and Limousine Commission. And with me are Diana Panetti, our Chief Enforcement, Luis Molina, our First Deputy Chief of Enforcement, and Mohamed Akinlolo, our Assistant Commissioner for Prosecution. Thank you for inviting me to testify today about TLC's enforcement efforts, Chair Diaz. I look forward to continuing to what has been a productive working relationship with you and working with the entire FHV community to strengthen all segments of the industry, including hardworking drivers, the bases that dispatch trips to them, our thousands of yellow and green taxis, and the millions of passengers who deserve safe, legal service that our licensees provide. The TLC community has had very difficult news in recent days. As many are aware, 3 men who had been licensed TLC drivers recently ended their lives. For those left behind, suicide leaves unanswered questions. What we do know is that we as a city must continue to focus strongly on expanding access to mental health services for anyone who needs support. At TLC, our focus has been and will continue to be on better understanding and attempting to lessen the stresses many of our drivers face. And I hope today we can discuss the steps TLC has already taken. Given today's focus on TLC enforcement, I also feel it's important to provide the committee and the public with an account of what happened just 2 weeks ago. On January 24th, two of our officers stopped a TLC-licensed vehicle operated by an unlicensed driver in the Bronx after seeing him illegally pick up a street hail. As our officers issued a summons to the driver, a crowd gathered, blocked the enforcement officer's vehicle with other vehicles, and verbally threatened them. The officers returned to their vehicle, and minutes later, a man wielding a metal baseball bat attacked their car, smashing in two of the windows while the officers remained in the vehicle. Miraculously, our officers were not harmed. This is an active NYPD investigation, and we're confident that the people who were involved with this violence will be prosecuted. Unprovoked, violent attacks on our officers will not be tolerated. I thank those, including Chair Diaz, who have publicly condemned such attacks. There are proven, peaceful ways to solve problems through communication and collaboration. The TLC, and especially the Enforcement Division, is always open to discussion and, as many of you know, incorporates driver feedback whenever possible. To understand our Enforcement Division, it's important to understand the agency and its mission. The Commission has 9 members, 5 of whom were appointed on the recommendation of the Council Borough delegations, and I'm proud to say that today some of those Commission members are with us. Commissioner Polanco, Commissioner Sorrentino, and Commissioner Aguado. Commissioner Polanco and Aguado have strong ties to Northern Manhattan and the Bronx, and both understand the value enforcement brings to these communities. TLC regulates the city's for-hire transportation industry, including yellow and green taxis, black cars, including traditional and app-based, livery, commuter vans, luxury limousines, and amulet vehicles, as well as their drivers and the businesses that support them. The number of our licensees has increased in the past 4 years. Today, we license almost 180,000 drivers and about 130,000 vehicles. These increased numbers have undoubtedly had an impact on the agency's finances and operations. For example, we've seen an increase in overall agency revenue due to an increase in the volume of license application and renewal fees, a natural result of the growing population of licensees. Even with this growth, our enforcement revenue has remained flat over the last 4 fiscal years.
Saying that in 2017, there were 1,678 straight place summonses in the Bronx. Only 909 in Queens and 336 in Manhattan and just 169 in Brooklyn. Now you're telling me something, the Central State telling me another thing, which one is lying to me?
So I believe Central Staff was informed, and your office was informed as well. 178 number for straight plate violations is listed under a column for the Bronx. It comes from our annual report. There is a mistake in our annual report. The boroughs of Brooklyn and the Bronx were switched.
You report on my staff?
Our report, and we informed Central Staff that there was
a mistake on your report.
There is a mistake on our report, and we informed your central staff of the mistake. 1,678 straight plate summons were issued in Brooklyn.
After the central staff called you off, Commissioner, why would you make a mistake like that?
The mistake was made. Your underlying point is how many straight plate summonses were issued in the Bronx. We publish that information month by month, every month. It's on our website. There is a mistake in the annual report, which is the top 10 violations for the entire year, but the month by month breakdown is on our website every month. And the number 1,678 is the number of straight plate summonses that were issued throughout the year.
In
Brooklyn. Because I see both lawyers on either side of you shaking their heads. They understand that the columns were switched, and the 1,678 number refers to Brooklyn. The number that refers to the Bronx is 169.
So TLC switched it, but it took them a year to figure it out. It took them to
your office, and thank you for coordinating with me, with Jenny Mejia, to be the liaison from my office to your office, so maybe we could do better for the driver. But I want to make clear to you and the central staff and to everyone, I didn't came here to play joke. I didn't came here to make believe. I came here to do a job. And I hope that we could do that job honestly, seriously, and without trying to mislead anyone. I want to be, see, you came to my office one year ago, when I was a senator. And I told you about, we discussed in my office the problem of enforcement. You brought, you knew the new inspector that you will appoint, that you have appointed to. And I told you about the abuse. You told me you're going to start a training where we're going to be more sensitive. But you know what happened? Instead of lowering down, the abuse increases. And the persecution and the thing increases. So I felt myself like ignored, laughed at. And I say, what's going on here?
That we meet with as a group or individually, if you have an experience with any one of our officers that's inappropriate, in order for us to take action against that officer, we need to know about it. You can report it anonymously. You don't need to put your name on it. So if you believe abuses have gone up, please send me all of that information so we can take prompt action.
Well, if you don't know that abuse is going on, I don't know what to tell you. People are killing themselves. Why do you think people are killing themselves?
So she's the designated number now.
Suicide is a tragic event.
It
for the individual, for the family left behind, and it leaves a lot of questions. There are so many factors that go into it. And all that we can do is hope that those that are feeling suicidal thoughts make sure that they reach out to the appropriate licensed professionals who can give them help.
You know, we have...
I have a lot of sympathy for drivers feeling the incredible stress that the increased number of cars, mostly caused by the increase in the use of Uber and Lyft, have meant on our streets. I was out at the vigil for Doug Shifter that some folks held last week, and I've had the opportunity to sit down both with the Independent Drivers Group and the New York Taxi Workers Alliance. I guess what I would say is that my sense is that the number one cause of that increased stress and the number one desire I've heard from a public policy point of view is to look at some pay regulations to raise the floor for drivers who find it harder and harder to earn a living with so many more cars on the road. And I know you referred to that briefly in your remarks here, but I feel like it would be valuable in light of the conversation about those tragedies, but also just the stress that you can palpably feel in the room. So I just wonder if you could reflect. I know that you've begun to take a look at regulations to raise the floor, think about whether something like you have in Yellows would make sense for for-hire vehicles. Can you just let me know what your plans are, what you're thinking, what listening you're doing?
A few years ago is becomes much more difficult today when they're competing among 180,000 drivers. There are more passengers, but there's not an infinite pie. So at some point, they make less money. With the yellow taxi drivers, we have pay protection and transparency. They know how much they're supposed to be paid, and there's a limit to how much anyone can lease a medallion or a taxi to them. So we're looking to do the same thing for our FHV drivers, so they can have certainty that on every trip, they'll make at least a certain amount. There are other parts to that problem. The expanding industry will continue to make driving a very stressful career without any kind of growth control mechanism.
It's an important industry, and the chairman of this committee, Reverend Diaz, I know that he would do a great job as a leader of this committee. As a chairman of the Transportation Committee, the last 4 years have been very tough for us working to balance the role, responsibility, and rights of members of this industry. I recognize that after Uber and Lyft and other tech company have arrived in New York City, it has also brought negative impact because many passengers are not there for delivery or green taxi industry. Also, we know that there's a lot of illegal pickup in front of the hotels in our JFK and LaGuardia. In the last 4 years, we've been working very hard to be sure that enforcement are mainly focused in Midtown. And I think that this is gonna be what I hope, a new change that in the new leadership of Ruben, Councilmember Diaz, and the administration, we can be able to explore the men and women who serve, especially in the outer borough, the Bronx, uptown Manhattan. Now they are responding for the need of many riders who put the demand in the market for a straight hill. However, we had to discuss with those drivers who own the green taxis, deliver the base owners, to come out with a conclusion that benefits everyone. Estoy de acuerdo con lo que ha señalado el Reverendo Díaz, de que cuando miramos el enforzamiento en la ciudad de Nueva York, el enfoque principal debe de ser frente a los hoteles, frente a los aeropuertos, en la parte del Midtown. Cuando tiene que ver con los servicios en la parte fuera del condado de Manhattan, en la parte alta del condado de Manhattan, del Bronx y los otros lugares, hay una demanda que son los mismos pasajeros que llaman a que los libres puedan recoger en esos lugares. Nosotros creemos de que en este momento donde lamentablemente se han perdido vidas de personas importantes, nuestras oraciones para esa familia que han perdido los seres queridos, pero yo tengo la esperanza de que en estos momentos nosotros podamos entrar a una conversación para balancear mejor los derechos y responsabilidades de los miembros de esta industria y que el enforzamiento se base fundamentalmente en Midtown, en los hoteles y los aeropuertos.
Hearing for New York City and for my district, the 13th congressional district in the city of New York. The New York City Taxi Limousine Commission, TLC, was created in 1971 as the oversight commission responsible for the licensing and regulation of New York City's medallion, yellow taxi cabs, for hire vehicles, community-based liveries, black cars and luxury limousines, commuter vans and paratransit vehicles. The commission established a board that consists of 9 members, 8 of whom are on salary commissions, while the paid chair commissioner presides over regularly scheduled public commission meetings and is the head of the agency. The TLC maintains a staff of approximately 600 employees assigned to various divisions and bureau. The TLC licenses and regulates over 50,000 vehicles and over 140,000 drivers. The commission is also responsible for the performing safety and emission inspections of more than 13,587 medallion taxicab 3 times each year, as well as a biannual inspection of TLC licensed for-hire vehicles, making the commission the most active taxi and limousine licensing regulatory agency in the entire United States. As of 2015, there were a total of more than 143,000 licensed taxi and for-hire vehicle drivers in New York City, including 13,587 yellow taxis in New York City and approximately 38,319 yellow cab drivers, 7,676 street hail livery cabs in New York City and approximately 13,455 street hail livery cab drivers. Additionally, there were 38,791 black car for hire vehicles, 21,932 livery cab for hire vehicles, and 5,881 luxury limo cars. There were also paratransit and commuter van operators in New York City, including 288 commuter van drivers for 584 vehicles, and 2,206 paratransit drivers for 1,123 vehicles. This industry faces great challenges. Taxi drivers face economic deprivation created by the fairly new influx of driving services and rideshare applications like Uber, Lyft, Juno, and Vio. It is difficult to distinguish between each of these rideshare services, considering that many drivers provide services for multiple companies. However, it is estimated that there are nearly 56,000 Uber vehicles in operation, just over 28,000 Lyft vehicles in operation, 17,038 Juno vehicles in operation, and nearly 6,000 Get vehicles in operation, as well as 4,000 Vio vehicles in operation. According to a 2017 New York Times article, Uber and Lyft cars outnumber yellow cabs in New York City, 4-1. In 2010, yellow cabs made 463,701 daily trips and brought in 5.17 million in daily fares during the month of November alone. 6 years later, the numbers have dropped, and in November 2006, the yellow cabs made an average of 336,737 daily trips and brought in 4.98 million in daily fares, according to the city data. In contrast, and according to the same report, Uber provides an average of 226.46 rides per day in October 2016. Lyft came in a distant second with 35,908 rides, according to city data, while Vio had 21,698, Juno had 20,426 rides, and Get, which launched in the city in 2014, came in with 7,227 rides. Why do individuals drive taxis? What are some of the benefits for driving a taxi in New York City? First, the taxi drivers have the ability to work hours rather than a 9-to-5 routine. While they can easily find work almost anywhere, as it is a regular work. Secondly, higher fares favor taxi drivers, especially during the weekends or busy times of the week. In addition, drivers are paid immediately and often are able to hold their earnings in their hand. Thirdly, the taxi industry was developed for and has long established practices that were developed to protect and create relatively stable income, unlike many new technology and share ride services. However, the influx of services like Uber has overtaken the industry and the market. The problems facing the city's taxi driver has become so bad that many taxi drivers roam around the city unable to pick up fares. Drivers face fear, isolation, and increased anxiety in their ability to make a living, their survival, and livelihood. The economic hardship that the car service like Uber and its competitor services have created is a stark reality for many New York City taxi drivers. The unconventional standards and unrealistic expectation for drivers in New York City has caused many individuals and long-term drivers to feel overwhelmed and anxious. Consider the economic strain and financial challenges that many drivers face. From 2013 to 2016, the gross annual car service booking of a full-time yellow taxi driver declined, falling from an annual salary of $88,000 a year to just over $69,000, resulting in increased bankruptcies, foreclosures, and evictions that plagued taxi drivers with mounting existential difficulties. Moreover, medallions which grant the right to operate a taxi in New York City are now depreciating assets, and drivers who borrow money to pay them, once a sound investment strategy, now many find themselves deeply in debt. New York City cab drivers are some of the hardest working drivers in the nation, entrusted with the duty of getting the riders to their destination safely and swiftly. They pay a premium to operate their yellow cabs service throughout the city, and at no fault of their own, the value of their medallion has plummeted while leaving many vulnerable and unable to pay the now exorbitant loan payments due to the market condition. Let me arrive at some conclusions. As you saw, Mr. Chairman, today, the commissioner presented a very dire and troubling picture of this industry. This is not an indictment on innovation. The TLC touts on its website that it is dedicated to fostering an environment that allows for-hire industry to provide safe, innovative, and accessible service. Yet we saw three drivers this year tragically take their lives. Yet the TLC has failed in its efforts to incorporate and open new technologies, provide better accessibility for customers, create competitive rate structures for drivers, and present transparency, easily available data such as trip records, fares, and routes. For hire and livery vehicles face exorbitant fines. La industria del taxi enfrenta multas muy altas, devastadoramente altas, including fees and fines for not keeping detailed records of passenger and trip records. Having outlined several issues of concern during my testimony today, Mr. Chairman, the TLC, I offer the following recommendations to your committee and to the City of New York for consideration to ensure transparency, accountability, innovation for New York City taxi for hire, liberal, and e-hail rideshare services. Yo le presento a usted, Presidente del Comité, las siguientes recomendaciones, dado el testimonio de la comisionada, la trágica muerte de tres choferes y la pendiente crisis que enfrenta la industria. I call for the immediate dismantlement of the TLC Commission and create a new entity that reflects the innovative and new modes of transportation, including rideshare application, such as use. Yo llamo a la inmediata eliminación de la Taxi Limousine Commission, ya que le ha fallado a los choferes, al público y naturalmente a la ciudad de Nueva York. Mr. Chairman, you face a great challenge. I would like to work with you in creating a new agency that will respond to the needs of all New Yorkers. The second recommendation calls for to establish new rules and regulations that incorporate modern-day rideshare platforms to equalize the market for all driving competitors and better streamline the process for customers. The third recommendation is to create a standalone enforcement unit for the TLC. La tercera recomendación es crear una unidad de enforzamiento que sea independiente de la nueva Taxi Limousine Commission, que no tenga ningún vínculo directo con el Taxi Limousine Commission, así asegurando transparencia en el proceso. The current system of enforcement and court system is under the purview of the TLC and does not provide car operators and drivers a due process and does not allow for a proper oversight to take place. Find solutions to the medallion debt that New York cab drivers face and allow greater flexibility to ensure continuing operation of their cabs and the ability for them to repay their loans. And the dual use of green cards by providing them from taking pre-arranged trips and limiting them to hail services, thus making livery and black cars the only prearranged service. Reduce the fines, que reduzcan dramáticamente la multa for hail ride services, for hail ride for livery and black car drivers and operators. Currently fines for for hire vehicles for picking up street hails in the outer boroughs are $500 for the first offense, $1,500 for the second offense, and a revocation of their license for the third offense. And below 96th Street, $2,000 for the first offense, $4,000 for the second offense, and $10,000 for the third offense. We must reduce dramatically this fine. We should cap the industry. We should place a cap on the bases and in the number of drivers out there. We cannot allow the industry to balloon to 200, 300,000 drivers in the city of New York. It is unsustainable. And finally, to create a greater regulation for ride-share services like Uber, más regulación para los servicios como de Uber, Lyft, and other e-health transportation services. Finally, Mr. Chairman, I want to bring greater attention to the troubling stories of entrapment. Quiero traer más énfasis a las demandas y las denuncias dramáticas del atrapamiento de los choferes, conducted by the roughly 200 enforcement inspectors in the TLC. Many operators of for-hire vehicles claim to have received large fines for picking up seemingly in-need individuals, only to find out that the prospective passenger was part of a larger network of fine distribution practices. Hemos visto la queja de muchos de los choferes que han recogido personas que aparentaba estar en necesidad, algunos con muletas, para después ver que eran realmente agentes de TLC que estaban involucrados en una práctica de atrapamiento y de no de mejoramiento del servicio en las calles de Nueva York. I am deeply troubled by the fact that of the top 10 enforcement summonses given out by the TLC in 2016, five of them were specifically for hire vehicle, the most of any TLC license type. As part of my continued efforts to ensure that all taxi drivers and for hire vehicles are treated equally, I will be sending a letter. Listen to me, Mr. Chairman. I will be sending a letter to the Department of Justice to request an impartial investigation of selective enforcement and entrapment practices and discrimination within the TLC. Le mandaré una carta como congresista al Departamento de Justicia para que investigue abiertamente el proceso de enforzamiento selectivo y las prácticas de atrapamiento y discriminación contra los choferes del TLC. It is my belief that the recommendations put forward to dismantle the TLC and rebuild the commission with a new agency will help create an equitable market for all New York taxi and for hire drivers and owners, as well as share ride services that will ensure transparency, accountability, and innovation for the New York City drivers and the customers they serve. Thank you for your time, Mr. Chairman, and I look forward to working with you.
Por favor, Mr. Congressman, it was an honor for me to serve with you in the State Senate, and I see it would be a great honor now that you are in the Congress and I'm here. To those of you there, you have to remember that all of this is happening . There have been people fighting organization, fighting and moving and crying for years. But a year ago, I think it was October 4, we formed a committee of 25 leaders. And those 25 of you that have been meeting with me, look at what you have done. Look at what you have done. Look at how we have come. You created a committee, especially this committee, for higher committee, is a consequence of those 25. They struggle, those that were meeting with me, and we continue meeting. Estoy diciendo que gracias al congresista, porque cuando estábamos en el Senado trabajando juntos, fue un honor para mí. Ahora, toda esa promesa, y este ha sido uno de los mejores reportes que yo he visto y que he tenido, y que juntos vamos a trabajar juntos con todo el equipo de abogados de aquí del Consejo para ver cómo podemos adelante. Pero quiero darle gracias a ese grupo de 25 líderes que se reunieron conmigo desde el principio, que estuvieron reuniéndose, aunque han habido muchas agencias, muchos grupos peleando y luchando por muchos años, pero en octubre 4 del año 2016, creo que fue, 16, se formó un comité de 25 líderes que se venían reuniendo conmigo. De ahí, de ese comité, mire dónde hemos llegado. Si este comité ahora existe, este comité de Fonjaya, estas vistas públicas se han dado, que ha sido histórica. Si esto ha sucedido, gracias a ese comité de 25, la lucha de ellos, ustedes fueron, ese comité de 25, fueron los que crearon este comité con la lucha, con su impulso. Y miren dónde hemos llegado. Miren qué reporte, miren cómo sentamos la comisionada, miren cómo el respaldo del congresista, una carta al Departamento de Justicia de parte del congresista. Yo quiero una copia de esa carta, congresista. Quiero que ustedes...
Bueno, señor presidente, señor presidente, yo espero trabajar muy cercanamente con usted para desmantelar y eliminar una comisión que sin duda está desfasada, es arcaica y que no le responde a la necesidad de la humanidad.
Gracias. Muchas gracias. Gracias. Gracias.
Gracias. Pedro Aguiar, presidente de la coalición de taxistas de Nueva York.
Jenny, will you translate that?
Yes, good morning. My name is Pedro Aguiar, president of Taxi Drivers Coalition of Taxi Drivers. Okay.
Reverendo Rubén Díaz, Chairman.
Reverend Rubén Díaz, Chairman.
Nosotros, en representación de los taxistas de Nueva York, queremos pedirle a esa comisión lo siguiente.
We, as representative of taxi drivers of New York, are asking the committee the following.
Primero, solicitarle a la comisionada de la TLC que le entregue a dicha comisión todas las regulaciones, principalmente la del año 2008 y 2009.
First of all, ask the commissioner to hand over to the committee all the regulations, especially from 2008-2009.
También queremos pedirle que si los pasajeros tienen el derecho sobre nosotros, nosotros, los taxistas, necesitamos el derecho del taxista, que usted como comisión, como comisionado, le reclame a la TLC de una vez por todas el derecho de nosotros, los taxistas.
Also, I would like to ask, since the passengers have passengers' rights, I would like to ask also for the drivers to have drivers' rights.
También quiero pedirle que los carros privados, principalmente, están acabando con nosotros.
Also, I would like to ask that the private plate vehicles are doing off with our industry.
Carro con placa de Pennsylvania, de Connecticut, de New Jersey, se están llevando nuestros pasajeros en nuestras áreas.
Plates from Pennsylvania, Rhode Island, Connecticut, and New Jersey are taking our passengers from our area.
Nosotros que pagamos un diamante, una registración y un seguro altísimo, somos perseguidos por la TLC y estos carros privados no.
We that pay an enormous amount of fines and insurance are being persecuted by taxi limousine and they're not.
Nosotros también queremos solicitarle a usted como comisionado que esa multa excesiva de $10,000, también queremos pedirle que usted como chairman le solicite a la comisionada y como bien lo pidió el congresista, que sea eliminada una vez por todas la TLC.
We would like to also ask those fines that we are receiving for you as chairman of the committee to take into consideration and avoid once and for all these high fines that we are receiving from Taxi Limousine Commission.
Quiero terminar con esto diciéndole a mis compañeros.
I want to conclude with this saying to my colleagues.
Que así como ustedes ven estas tres flores, estas tres rosas.
The same way you see these three roses.
Que representan los tres compañeros de nosotros que se quitaron la vida, el compañero.
That represent those three drivers that lost their lives.
El compañero Alfredo Pérez de la base de Yunica que se ahorcó.
Alfredo Pérez, he hanged himself.
El compañero Danilo Corporán que por dos multas de 1,500 se lanzó de un quinto piso en el Alto Manhattan.
As well as Danilo Corporán, because of the excessive fines, he jumped from a rooftop.
Y el pasado lunes, frente aquí a la alcaldía, Douglas Schister se dio un disparo en la cabeza.
And last Monday, right in front of City Hall steps, Douglas Schister shot himself in his head.
Que en este momento, todas las organizaciones de taxistas, todas las organizaciones de la industria, trabajemos unidos con representación de estos compañeros muertos en las últimas semanas.
As of today, I would like to ask that we all work together in memory of these three drivers that lost their lives due to the industry.
Gracias al grupo de los 25 y gracias Rubén Díaz.
Thank you to the 25 people of the commission and thank you Rubén Díaz.
Yeah. Thank you God for giving me the opportunity. Buenas tardes, distinguidas personalidades aquí presentes en esta honorable sala municipal.
Good afternoon, distinguished personalities present in this municipal room.
A cada uno de ustedes, señores concejales.
Su nombre.
Mi nombre es, perdón, Héctor Leonardo Germán, cariñosamente, 1-2-2.
My name is Héctor Leonardo Germán, also known as 1-2-2.
A cada uno de ustedes, señores concejales, que forman ese nuevo comité especial, especialmente un saludo grande de parte de todos los taxistas, reverendo Rubén Díaz.
To all the councilmen, especially to our dear Reverend Rubén Díaz Sr., who presides over this new committee for the vehicle for hire under the supervision of TLC.
Y un saludo especial a ese público maravilloso que hoy está presente con nosotros, especialmente a nuestro compañero taxista de lucha y de supervivencia.
And a special hello to all the people here today, especially to all taxi drivers that are here today.
Que hoy serán testigos de uno de los eventos de mayor importancia que los trabajadores de servicio de taxi hayamos tenido alguna vez.
That today will be witness to one of the greatest moment that the taxi industry has had in a long time.
Esperamos que con nuestra participación al final podamos arrojar aportaciones positivas en ara de buscar soluciones a tantos problemas que hoy tenemos los taxistas de esta ciudad.
We hope that with our participation in the end we are able to provide positive contributions to find solutions to so many problems that the taxi driver has today in your city, but mainly to take us with solutions that are real, economical, social, and above all, humanitarian for our drivers.
Y al final, al término de la misma, llevaremos con nosotros soluciones reales y de carácter económico, social y más que otro de carácter humanitario. Hoy aquí presente están parte de los responsables de ese suicidio inducido de nuestros compañeros taxistas. Y cuando decimos inducido, es por las condiciones que nos han creado para que tomemos, nosotros tomemos esa funesta decisión.
Present today here are part responsible, the people that are, I'm sorry, that are responsible for the suicides of so many of our friends in the last few months, and
tenemos,
we must hold them responsible.
Tenemos nosotros los taxistas que responsabilizar directamente al gobernador Andrew Cuomo, que con su política ambiciosa y prepotente no titubeó entregar todos los derechos y poderes a esas empresas de transporte telefónica como son Uber, Lyft, Via, etcétera, etcétera.
We also must hold responsible directly our governor Andrew Cuomo, that with his ambitious and arrogant policy didn't hesitate and gave all the rights and power to the apps company like Uber, Lyft, Via and others.
Y resaltamos Uber porque es la que realmente ha puesto los precios por el piso y nuestra industria libre prácticamente ha perdido todos los costumes. Más de un 63% de los costumes que tenían servicio con nosotros ya están en la aplicación.
We'll use Uber as an example, since it's the company that has affected the most to our industry, with a 63% of the customer leaving our industry to go with Uber.
Podemos seguir explicando, pero ya todo se ha dicho. Pero antes, nosotros queremos primero pedirle a los concejales, a todas las autoridades, que le den derecho plenipotenciario a ese nuevo comité encabezado por nuestro reverendo Rubén Díaz.
We would like to ask all councils and authorities to please give this committee all their support that is, that has started being with Reverend Díaz as the head of this committee.
Muy importante, nosotros los taxistas nos abrazamos a esa propuesta del congresista Ariano Epayá de que la TLC sea desmantelada, pero antes nosotros queremos que sea interpelada porque la TLC tiene mucho dinero de los hombres de trabajo que deben ser devueltos.
Okay. We would like, we want to support the proposals brought by the Congressman Adrián Espaillat about TLC being dismantled. But before, we would like the TLC to be held accountable for many of the summons that they have issued our taxi drivers, which they have enriched themselves.
También nosotros queremos que la ley de recogida en la calle, sobre todo el Boro Taxi, esa ley sea revisada porque realmente no está cumpliendo con los objetivos para lo que fue creada en la en los altos de los boros.
Okay. Street hail and Boro Taxi must be reviewed immediately because it has not complied with the service needed in the uptown areas where they were mainly operate and for which they were created.
Nosotros nos encontramos dándole un servicio a la parte alta de los boros, aún sabiendo que hay una ley que nos impide recoger legalmente en la calle, pero no pasa un carro verde, no pasa un amarillo, y el ciudadano no tiene una ley que le impida subirse con nosotros.
We are providing a service to the uptown area of the boroughs, which no green car or yellow taxis are found, and even though the customer is not aware that they're breaking the law, we are providing a service for them.
Inmediatamente nosotros le vamos a pedir a ese honorable comité revisar inmediatamente las regulaciones y leyes que hoy ejecutan la TLC.
¿Cuánto tú debes hacer una pregunta? Usted acaba de decir que en la parte alta no hay green, no hay hielo. Y que ustedes tienen que servir allá. Pero hay bases para que los llamen ustedes y les den un número, ¿no? Y le den y los llamen a las bases, le digan a las bases, vengan. Las bases le están dando ustedes.
Es correcto, pero nosotros cuando le hacemos la pregunta a un pasajero que está en la calle, dice: yo tengo más de 45 años saliendo de mi casa y tomando el carro aquí. Como no hay una ley que lo obligue, nosotros le decimos: tenga esa tarjeta, llame a la base. Y dice: no, yo tengo 50 años y hago esto mismo. Entonces, aquí estamos para que le busquemos verdadera salida a los problemas. Okay. Y para terminar, nosotros queremos la eliminación inmediata de ese programa que fue creado por la señora que estaba aquí, de manejo crítico. Que eso...
We would like to the elimination of the program of critical driving that was created by the Commissioner Mira Joshi. Also, the taxi, a lot of people are being held in the street because they have always done that. So.
Bien, entonces, para terminar, nosotros, este es el tiempo de nosotros, taxistas, lo sufrido allá afuera. Revelar, nosotros queremos que ese comité inmediatamente reevalúe los precios que tienen las empresas de transporte telefónico.
We would like the committee to reevaluate the prices that the apps have in order to be fair to all drivers.
Y ya se dijo, disminuir o paralizar la emisión de placas, que abusivamente más de 2,000 placas están saliendo todos los meses.
Reduce or stop the emission of new plates for taxis, which they said that more than 2,000 plates are coming out from Albany every month.
Dijo Douglas, escuchen bien, dijo Douglas, que esperaba que su descapitación o su suicidio no fuera en vano. Nosotros, los taxistas, en el día de hoy, esperamos que todo lo que se ha dicho, que realmente tampoco quede en el vacío.
Primeramente quiero darle las gracias a Bárbara Flores.
Good afternoon, my name is Balbuena Flores.
Primeramente quiero darle las gracias a Dios.
First, I would like to give thanks to God.
Por darnos la oportunidad de estar aquí todos tus hermanos del volante.
To give thanks to all of us that are here, especially our drivers behind the wheel.
Para mí es un honor poder estar con un hispano representando a toda la comunidad en general, el reverendo Rubén Díaz.
For me, it's an honor to have you in front of all of us representing the Hispanic, Reverend Rubén Díaz.
Tengo la confianza en Dios y en el reverendo Rubén Díaz y su equipo de trabajo.
I have a lot of faith in God, Reverend Rubén Díaz, and his team of advisors.
Para nadie es un secreto.
For no one, it's a surprise.
Que la TLC maltrata a los hombres y mujeres del volante de la ciudad de Nueva York.
That TLC mistreats drivers behind the wheel of the city of New York.
Tanto que le pasa por encima al consejo de la ciudad, al alcalde Vidi Blasio.
It is so severe that it overpasses the city mayor Bill de Blasio.
Y le pasa por encima a la Constitución de los Estados Unidos, violándola.
And it passes the Constitution of the United States, violating.
Porque la Constitución me dice a mí.
Because the Constitution tells me.
Que un estadounidense no puede ser multado dos veces por lo mismo.
You cannot be found guilty twice for the same act.
Donde la TLC tiene esta práctica a diario con los hombres y mujeres del volante.
In which Taxi Limousine Commission has this practice on a daily basis behind our men and women behind the wheel.
Donde el Departamento de Tránsito te da un somo de $300.
Where the Department of Transit gives you a summons of $300.
Y la TLC le pasa por encima a ese somo con $1,000.
TLC surpasses that summons with the amount of $1,000.
En medio de todos estos hermanos del volante, hombres trabajadores que salen a las calles.
On behalf of all my colleagues that we
a buscar el pan, the streets, a buscar el pan de su familia.
To find our bread of our family.
Y dándole un servicio a la comunidad.
And giving the community a service.
De primera clase.
A first class.
Porque cuando usted va a buscar a su puerta y lo lleva después a la otra puerta, eso es un servicio que no tiene precio.
Because when you're going to pick up a passenger from door to door, that doesn't have a price.
El Reverendo Rubén Díaz.
Reverend Rubén Díaz.
Yo sé que no va a hacer milagro porque los milagros lo hace Dios.
We know he's not going to make miracles because miracles are performed by God.
Pero sí le puede buscar soluciones a los hombres y mujeres de volante que son maltratados en esta ciudad, como por ejemplo la multa agresiva.
But yes, he will find solutions to our men and women behind the wheel of a vehicle.
Que llegan de $100 hasta los $10,000.
Where it's anywhere from $100 to $10,000.
Es imposible que la TLC le pase por encima al Departamento de Tránsito, donde una multa lo que llega son como a unos $400.
It is impossible to surpass the Department of Transit on a fine of $400.
Reverendo, nosotros los hombres y mujeres del volante queremos solución.
Reverend, us women and men behind a wheel want solutions.
Porque estamos cansados de que las palabras se queden en el aire.
Because we are tired that the words are being dispensed in air.
Y públicamente le pido aquí a usted.
And publicly I am asking you.
Que yo sé que usted no va a hacer milagros, pero sí puede buscar mejoría dentro de la solución.
That I know you will not perform miracles, but you will find solutions for our problem.
Gracias y que la bendición de Dios descienda sobre todos nosotros aquí y todos los que andan en alrededor de City Hall.
Thank you. Gracias. And the blessings will overshine among us and everyone here. Sí,
Reverendo Rubén Díaz, honorables concejales, buenos días a todos los presentes. Soy Leonel Marte. No soy presidente de una organización más o menos.
Good afternoon, Reverend Councilman Díaz and all the councilmen that are present. My name is Leonel Marte.
Estoy como mentor de la organización Coordinadora General de Taxista, CGT.
I am the mentor of an organization called CGT.
Nosotros, como toda la comunidad taxista,
we as the community of taxi drivers,
estamos altamente preocupados por la ola de suicidio que se está efectuando en los últimos 9 meses.
We are highly concerned of all the suicides that have been committed within the last 9 months.
Estamos aquí con un propósito claro.
We are here for a purpose.
Exigirle a este honorable consejo de la ciudad y fundamentalmente al Reverendo Díaz.
To ask the council members of the city, especially Rubén Díaz.
Que llegó la hora. Yo creo que basta con lo que ha sucedido en esta comunidad, que alguien debe de interesarse.
The time has come where someone within this community is interested.
Por esta comunidad de hombres y mujeres trabajadores.
For this community of men and women.
Que solamente nosotros nos levantamos, nos encomendamos a Dios.
When we wake up and empower ourselves to God.
Y salimos a la calle a buscar el pan de nuestra familia.
And we come out to the streets. to look for the sustain of our daily needs.
La CGT quiere ser completamente breve para darle participación a los demás.
The organization CGT wants to be very brief in order to give others the same opportunity.
Y dejarle una cosa clara a ustedes concejales y a todos los que están aquí presentes.
And to all the members and the councilmen that are here present.
Esa TLC, a nuestro juicio, debe ser desmantelada, debe ser investigada por el Departamento de Justicia.
We feel that the TLC committee should be investigated and dismantled.
Y debería crearse una nueva comisión que regularice.
And should be, they should organize a new committee, a new taxi limousine commission.
La comunidad
they will organize the community of the taxi drivers.
Multa de $3,000, $1,500, $10,000.
Fines of $3,000,
$5,000,
and $10,000.
Eso no es justo con hombres y mujeres que salen a la calle.
It's not fair to men and women that come out to the streets.
A montar un pasajero de $7, $8, y $10.
To carry a passenger of $7, $8, and $10.
Automáticamente, finalmente, cuando la TLC te da una multa excesiva,
automatically, when Taxi Limousine Commission gives you an excessive fine,
usted no tiene recursos para pagarla, y ahí viene la mente suicida. Muchísimas gracias, soy Leonel Mate.
You do not have the money to pay for these excessive fines, and that's where the suicide comes
Mr.
upon
Duarte,
the drivers. My name is Leonel Mate.
Mr. Duarte and Mr. Aguilar, I wanted to under arrest for the two appreciation, because you have spent time with me when the group of 25 trying to deal with this problem, so I would like for you to continue working with me in that group, and thank you for being here today. Estoy diciendo al señor Duarte, al señor Aguilar, gracias a todos los que están testificando.